Welcome to another amazing video from Team Supreme Gamers. I'm your host Ghostface, and this is the first episode of our new series called Popcorn Time. There are no tutorials today, only me telling you about my experience and knowledge with Android x86. So just sit back, grab some popcorn, and enjoy the show.
Hi, welcome to Mountain View, California. I'm speaking here at Google's headquarters. And I'd like to tell you about something I'm really excited about. It's called Android, and it's a new open source operating system and software platform for mobile phones.
In July 2005, Google acquired Android Incorporated, a company led by Andy Rubin, which was working on an unspecified software for mobile devices. Under the leadership of Google, the team was in the process of developing a standardized Linux-based operating system for mobile phones to compete against the likes of Symbian and Windows Mobile. Later in September 2008, HTC launched its first Android smartphone called the HTC Dream. The Dream was the first commercially released device to use the Linux-based Android operating system, which was further developed by Google and the Open Handset Alliance to create an open competitor to other major smartphone platforms of the time, such as Nokia Symbian, BlackBerry OS, and Apple iOS. The operating system offers a customizable graphical user interface, integration with Google services such as Gmail, a notification system that shows a list of recent messages pushed from apps, and Android App Store for downloading additional apps. The Dream was praised for its solid and robust hardware design, but the introduction of the Android operating system was met with criticism for its lack of certain functionality and third-party software in comparison to more established platforms, but was still considered to be innovative due to its open nature, notification systems, and integrations with Google services. Due to the open-source nature of the Android platform, the Dream became a popular target for modding. Shortly after the release of the Dream, developers discovered a software exploit which would allow a user to gain superuser access to the phone, a process which would be referred to as rooting. As a parallel to jailbreaking on iOS devices, root access would enable users to perform tweaks and other changes at the system level that cannot be performed under normal circumstances, such as removing stock apps and installing a custom kernel that gives better performance and more hardware support. As a result of these developments, a dedicated community, centered around forums such as XDA developers, emerged surrounding the creation of custom ROMs built for the Android source code. Projects such as CyanogenMod continued to produce ports of newer versions of Android for the Dream and later Android devices, while adding their own features and enhancements to the operating system as well. In 2009, developers Chiwi Huang and Yi Sun began a series of patches to the Android open source project to enable Android to run on various netbooks, tablets, and PCs. The original plan was to host different patches for Android x86 support from open source community, and a few months after that, they found out that they could do much more than just hosting patches. So they decided to create their own code base and provide support on different x86 platforms. That's how Android x86 was born, an unofficial porting of Google's Android OS to run on devices powered by AMD and Intel x86 processors. Yi later quit due to personal affairs. Chiwi is the current project maintainer, and current active developers team includes Mauro Rossi, Michael Coffio, and some other people over the Android x86 community that provides various patches and bug fixes to the project. Like a normal Linux distribution, the project releases pre-built ISO images which can run under live mode or installed to a hard disk on the target system. With the release of Android x86 4.4, the project was attracting many enthusiasts, like me who wanted to play some Android games on bigger screens. The OS was fast, lightweight, and can give a new life to your old laptop and desktop. In October 2015, first release candidate for Android x86 5.1 was released to the public, which brings the support for 64-bit kernel and user space, as well as a 32-bit system, and support for ARM and ARM64 apps via the native bridge was also introduced. The Android x86 5.1 quickly became popular in the Android community, and as a result, some forks like PopcornTime and PhoenixOS started to build their own custom projects over Android x86. In 2016, Jide Technologies partnered with Chewy on PopcornTime, a closed-source derivative of Android x86, designed for use on conventional PCs. Jide was initially working on porting PopcornTime to Nexus 9 and 10 tablets, which gives Android OS a Windows-like UI with support for keyboard and mouse. They also partnered with some Chinese hardware companies to sell tablets and mini PCs with PopcornTime on it. It quickly became popular in the Chinese market. Later on, they decided to move towards Android x86 to build PopcornTime on PC. PopcornTime on PC was fast, elegant, and beautiful like its tablet version. That's why it even got Best of MWC 2016 award from Android Authority.
At Jide, we believe that the future of computing is Android, and we aspire to usher in a new era of exploration, transformation, and inspiration the world has never seen before. To create and to collaborate in amazing ways, to work and play together. The past has already been written, but we are here today to write the future. That's why we believe in what Alan Kay once said, the best way to predict the future is to invent it. PopcornTime, for the revolutionaries who will shape tomorrow.
Unlike Android x86, PopcornTime PC has multi-window support that can quickly drag and drop things from one app to another, and for the first time, people have seen a key mapper in Android x86 that can simulate on-screen touches in a game, which opened a whole new era of gamers in the Android x86 platform. But in the tech community, more people means more bugs, and you can spend 6 to 8 hours a day to find and troubleshoot all the problems, but bugs still won't stop coming. Since the project like PopcornTime and Android x86 rely on donations, it's hard to keep doing things for free for a longer duration. Jide Technologies was also selling hardware with PopcornTime pre-installed in them, but the project needed more developers, and to get more developers, first you need to open source your project, but PopcornTime was closed source from the beginning. So on July 17th of 2017, Jide announced that development of PopcornTime for PC, as well as other related consumer projects, was being discontinued, and the company would be restructuring their approach to PopcornTime and transitioning away from the consumer space. Later on, Jide rebranded PopcornTime, which was being developed for Nexus 9 and 10 tablets, to Jide OS. Now they are selling Jide Pro 2, which is an ARM-based tablet, and only sold in China because selling hardware is more profitable than software, and Asian people always want best and cheap devices that can do the same job. But Jide Technologies was not the only company working to modify Android x86.
Nice. And this is a UI that's called Phoenix?
Yes, this is one of our partner called Phoenix.
Yeah.
What they're trying to do is to create a Windows-like environment.
But it's beautiful. It's like Android and all the apps are right here. And it feels like, basically it feels like Windows, right? Like all the apps are over here. And the notifications are over here. So people are not going to like panic and not know what to do. Yep. They would be used to it.
Yeah.
In MWC 2016, Chaozhou Technology also showed their first phoenixos OS x86 build, which was based on Android x86 5.1. And with the help of some bigger manufacturing companies like TLC, they showed some of their devices running phoenixos OS in MWC. Chaozhou built phoenixos OS Studio with some R&D members from Qiho 360, which is a Chinese antivirus company. And together they started working on phoenixos OS x86. Chaozhou was a small company compared to Remix OS, but their OS was great. Just like Remix OS, phoenixos OS was also closed source, with a lot of improved features intended to improve and optimize both OSs for newer applications and PCs. Like Jade, Chaozhou also had an ARM version of phoenixos OS, and sells hardware in China with phoenixos OS pre-installed. The main feature that differentiates phoenixos OS from other Android x86 forks is its Octopus Key Mapper. The company's main product, the Phoenix One console, was focused on gaming and selling the phoenixos OS devices to the new emerging Android gaming market in China. After Remix OS stopped its development, people started looking for an alternative OS, and phoenixos OS's UI was not elegant and fast like Remix OS, but Chaozhou was actively working on developing its Octopus Key Mapper and also updating the base Android x86 OS. The initial development builds were based on Android x86 5.1, but later on they moved to Android x86 7.1, which also includes a new key mapping system that allows users to play modern games like PUBG Mobile and Honkai Impact on low-end laptops or PCs. Due to popularity of these mobile games, there was a big rise in phoenixos OS community users, and some people even added their own custom tweaks in the OS, like boot animations, wallpapers, and deep loading some system apps with better alternatives, and called themselves developers for no reason at all. And the best part of it is phoenixos OS team allowed them to do so on their own website forums. But they have to follow some basic rules, like including VIP ad service, which is useful for them to collect donations and keep the project running. And since we are also part of this modding community since last year, I've got a lot of drama for you guys, which really deserves a separate video, and we are going to cover that in upcoming episodes. In October 2018, FloydWiz Technologies, an Indian company with a small team of developers, released their own version of Android x86 7.1 called Prime OS. Prime OS looks and feels a lot like Remix OS. The system UI was great and responsive, and it also had a key mapper called DiCapro, although compared to Octopus Key Mapper, it wasn't good. Prime OS was still in beta, but overall, performance of the OS was better than phoenixos OS, which was dominating the Android x86 gaming community at the time. Prime OS quickly became popular among the Android community, and like Phoenix and Remix OS, they also kept their project closed-sourced and partnered with some third-party hardware companies to sell devices with Prime OS pre-installed in them. But 6 months after the first release of Prime OS, the team suddenly stopped the development without any announcements, and now the rumors say some of the main developers have left the company too. Despite being popular and feature-rich, none of these companies contributed or open-sourced their projects for future development. Android x86 is an open-source project, and open-source allows you to showcase the developer community, the interesting challenges you face, and how you think about solving them. and other open source developers can casually contribute to projects to learn how you work and what it's like developing software for a particular set of challenges. Any new patches, bug fixes, or custom apps are always welcomed by the Android x86 community. There are other projects like Bliss OS for PC and OpenThoughts, which is an OS focused on Chinese users, but it's totally open source. And Bliss OS is based on Bliss ROM, which is an AOSP-based ROM for Android smartphones. Bliss OS for PC was based on AOSP Oreo builds, and it was first launched in January 2017, about 1 year and 6 months before the Android x86 first Oreo-based release candidate. So the development of Bliss OS is pretty fast, all thanks to John West, aka Electric Jesus, and its team. With the Android Pie builds, Bliss OS took a different approach to building Android for PCs. Taking inspiration from PH Husun's treble methods, Intel's Project Celadon, and Android x86 project, they have adapted this method to be a bit more streamlined and packaged it up so that it can work a bit more dynamically. Bliss OS x86 builds are fast and snappy, and they also ship some experimental builds with Vulkan API support. There are a lot of things to talk about Bliss OS, but we'll cover them in future episodes. OpenThoughts is another Chinese fork of Android x86, which looks very similar to Phoenix OS, but it's open source. Although the development is really slow compared to other OSs, but the project is still under development, and the latest build of OpenThoughts is based on Android 8.1, and it's still in its beta version. The project is maintained and developed by students and developers from Tsinghua University and Tongfeng Company Limited. Recently, a lot of big gaming companies like Tencent, Garena, NetEase, and even EA Games are investing a lot of money in mobile gaming. And while playing mobile games on a big monitor screen is not only fun, but you can also dominate mobile users in FPV games with keyboard and mouse. Since not everyone has the kind of luxury to afford a new and expensive smartphone, people tend to look for some alternatives, and Android x86 is free. And with forks like Phoenix OS, it's a cheap thrill for gamers. So that's all for the first episode of Popcorn Time. I hope you've learned something new today. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe the video, and stay tuned for the next episode.